Bonjour everyone and welcome to my channel The Waves of Your Soul. My name is Marine, I'm a French tarot reader and I'm super excited to be doing my May astro readings for all of my Tauruses out there. So if your sun, moon or rising sign is in Taurus, this is gonna be the reading for you and we're gonna be looking at what the month of May 2021 has in store for you, the energy of the month, what can possibly get in your way this month, as well as what you need to focus on, what is the gift this month has for you, and finally getting a message from your guides and your higher self. As with all of my readings, I always want to point out that they are for the collective. So please use your intuition, your inner knowing, to take what resonates with you and just leave the rest. Not everything might speak to your soul and that's okay. You'll know exactly what is meant for you and what is not. However, I'm trying to make those astro readings a little bit more personalized. So in front of you, you're going to find two cards. This is going to be card number one right here. And this is going to be card number two right here. Those two cards are representing messages from your guides or messages from your higher self. And what I'm asking you to do is during the reading, intuitively decide which is the card that's calling out to you the most. We'll be checking them out at the end of the reading and you'll get a little bit more of a specific message. So I'm going to leave them right here for now. Like I said, we'll check them at the end. But during the reading, you can decide which one is calling out to you the most. Okay, so all my Tauruses out there, let's check out first what is the energy of the month of May. What is gonna be, you know, the weather report, just like a weather report for doing an energy report of what's the month gonna look like for you, my Tauruses. I'm using the Cosmic Cycle Tarot for anyone wondering and I always leave the names of my cards in the descriptions down below for anyone who's interested. Okay, so my Tauruses, month of May 2021, let's see what the month has in store for you. Three of Pentacles and Five of Swords. Okay, beautiful. This is interesting. See how there's the same characters on this particular deck? In those two cards, this is very interesting. So we have the Three of Pentacles here, and we have the Five of Swords here. And it literally looks like the same two characters, right? They look like the same two people, which I think is very interesting. So we have the Three of Pentacles and the Five of Swords. Three of Pentacles talks about collaboration, talks about working on a project or some kind of, or at work or in your family or on, you know, working towards a goal, but making sure that you are asking people's help and asking people's, asking other people to join you and to collaborate with you. And the Five of Swords talks about competition. Almost to the point where there could be a little bit of jealousy. As you can see in this particular card, it's very well depicted. Like this character right here is playing video games and he won. And obviously, I guess he won against his friend and his friend is not feeling too happy about it. So, which is, you know, it's sometimes we win, sometimes we lose, right? So what is the theme for the months ahead for my Tauruses? There's this idea very much, especially because we have the same characters, where you are being asked to collaborate, you are being in your work or in your family or in your friendships, but I'm sensing a lot, for a lot of you it's around work or career or you know, maybe even hobbies, something like that. You're having to spend a lot of time with other people and work on projects with other people, and maybe it's something that you're not quite comfortable doing. Maybe it's not even people you originally chose to work with. It feels like it wasn't something that you chose. It feels like it was a bit imposed on you, and there might be a little bit of unhealthy competition there, where people could be a little bit jealous of your skills, or they could be feeling a little bit left down if you're getting more credit than them, or maybe you're seeing other people take the credit for work that you've done, my Tauruses. It could be the other way around. There's a bit of a here, you know, a bit of like, I'm sensing the balance of the relationship is not quite straight, right? So someone is getting more than they should and someone is not getting as much as they should. Now, where you are on the scale will depend on your situation, will depend on your, you know, what's going on in your life. But definitely, if you're having to collaborate on a certain project or working in a team or working in a group, or even having to spend more time with some family members or some friends, one of you is feeling left out and one of you is feeling like there's just this sense, yeah, where maybe you feel like you're not getting as much in return as the energy you put in. Maybe you feel like people are not listening to you as much as you listen to them. Or maybe other people are feeling that about you and they're projecting a little bit of jealousy. But there's definitely a sense of a little bit of competition or tension there. Nothing too heavy, but something to be aware of considering this is the energy of the month. If you're feeling a little bit tense or a little bit stressed or you're feeling a bit iffy, some people are, you know, giving you some off vibes. This could be why, something to explore. Have a think about where the relationship could be quite unbalanced and not feeling quite fair, either for yourself or for the person in front of you. Okay, we're going to be putting some seashells and find out a little bit more about the information. About the energy of the month for my Tauruses. And we have, see, didn't I talk about the scale? We have Justice here. We have the Fool as well as Jupiter. So we have the Fool, the Scale, and Jupiter. Let me bring them closer. I just made this oracle myself, by the way. I drew on seashells I found on the beach where I lived, so excuse the very poor drawing skills, but hopefully you'll get it. So Jupiter, the Scale, which we talked about, and the Fool. So it's I was just speaking about some kind of balance and equilibrium, and we have Justice here, which reinforces the message I was just talking about. With the Fool and Jupiter together, this is a very beautiful energy coming into your life. So for my Tauruses, there could be a new influx of new energy in the month of May as well, where you're being asked to take a leap of faith. Jupiter is expansion. It's the planet of expansion, of literally going out there, of trusting that you are worth it and that you can expand, that you can succeed, that you can be abundant. It's a very beautiful kind of energy of faith, positivism, hope, etc. As it rules Sagittarius, right, which is the sign of the traveler, the someone who's not afraid to go out there in the world and to explore, which very much goes well with the Fool. So in the month of May, you are being encouraged, my Tauruses, to take a leap of faith, go outside your comfort zone, push your boundaries a little bit, go explore a little bit. What can you do to go outside of your routine? What can you do to shake things up? What can you do to jump off the cliff? And, you know, as the Fool, if you're familiar with the tarot, in the Fool we see this character like jumping off a cliff, ready to start anew, but obviously not in like a dangerous way, because we don't know if there's like a path underneath that cliff. So it's more a sense of like taking a leap of faith, starting something new, fresh, optimism, positivism, faith, hope, etc., which is a beautiful energy. So those two together are definitely asking you to take that leap of faith, start something fresh, go out there, embrace the Fool, and embrace this spontaneity and positivity in the month of May. If you've been putting off starting something, if you've been putting off getting outside your comfort zone and trying something new, May is the month to do that, my Tauruses. And it's, for a lot of you, your birthdays, so it's a perfect timing to manifest some new things, to try some new things, you know, use that birthday lovely energy to start a new cycle in your life. Because Fool is number zero in tarot, remember? So, and that paired with Jupiter, it's a very beautiful pairing. Okay, so now let's see, what can be getting in your way in the month of May, sorry, my Tauruses. So we know a little bit more of the energy, but let's have a look at what could be standing in your way. What could be the lesson or the challenge of the month of May for my Tauruses? We have the Ace of Swords and the Five of Cups. Okay, so with the Five of Cups, we have a sense of grieving, of sadness, of mourning, some kind of loss. And that paired with the Ace of Swords, it's like Ace of Swords representing a new idea, a new way of thinking, a new habit, a new fresh start. So what could be getting in your way is, for some of you, you're having a little bit of a tough time letting go of the past and embracing a new habit, embracing a new idea, embracing a new way of life. For some of you, you've had to say goodbye to something or someone, some situations or people or jobs in your life recently, maybe even some habits and way of life. You've had to say goodbye to those, leave them behind, mourn the loss of them. And it's not been easy, because of course every loss is difficult, and you're having a little bit of a hard time letting go, my Tauruses, in the month of May, where you know, you just want to hold on to what you've already lost, and the universe is telling you, you know what, it's just, you need to let go now, you need to open your palm. There's nothing there for you to hold on to anymore. What you need to look at is look ahead, and remember to, if you think about this kite flying, it's like, look ahead instead of looking back at the past, at what has happened. Look at the beauty of what you want to create in the future, and also look at the beauty that's happening now. Focus on the present moment and on what you can do to change your circumstances and to invite newness in your life. If you've lost something, if you've grieved, if you've been mourning, even though it's really difficult, it also means that there's now space for you in your life to welcome something new. So what is it that you want to welcome? What are the intentions, the seeds you want to plant? What are the new habits, the new thoughts you want to invite in your head and in your life, in your way of thinking, the new habits you want to create, the new way of life, etc.? With this Ace of Swords, this is very much what the universe is telling you, my Tauruses. So that's could be what be getting in your way and something you need to make sure you work on this month. Okay, so let's have a look now at what you need to focus on, what requires your full attention in the month of May, my Tauruses. Like I said, for a lot of you, it's your birthday, so this is an exciting month. So we want to know what you need to focus on. We have the Eight of Cups. Okay, so you really need to let go. And death. Okay. Seriously, guys and girls and everyone else, you need to let go. This couldn't be any clearer. You know, when you sometimes you think, okay, I got the message, and the tower is like, just in case you didn't get the message, let me tell you like three times with three different cards. Eight of Cups, Death, and the Five of Cups are very much cousins, sisters, you know, they live in the same family tree. So what you need to focus on is moving on, start new. Look at this death card in this particular deck. I love it. I think it's so powerful, this specific death card, because it really talks about starting a fresh cycle. I mean, for anyone who has been, who's ever cut their own hair, you know what a powerful ritual that is. That is literally deciding to leave the old you behind and create a new version of yourself. This is like you 3.0. And with the Eight of Cups, there is a sense of walking away from something, of deciding that you are choosing priorities over something else, of deciding to, you know, not look back anymore and make a decision and commit to it. So what you need to focus on in the month of May, my Tauruses, is to stop looking at behind you, stop looking at the past, and just embrace where you're going. Look ahead. So you need to focus on how you can create a new version of yourself, on how you can also accompany yourself while you're mourning some kind of loss, while you're going through some kind of grieving. You need to make sure you're being compassionate with yourself, you're being gentle with yourself, but that also you're looking ahead and you're deciding to move on and transform. This is very Phoenix energy for my Tauruses. You're rising from the ashes. It's not been easy to get there, but now you want to embrace this new rebirth. And what do you want to be rebirthed into? What do you want your life to be now, my Tauruses? Remember, we had the Fool and Jupiter. What do you want to start fresh? We are starting a whole new cycle. So put the intentions out there, leave the past where it belongs, and just focus on the now, as well as putting the intentions for your future, because this is definitely what the universe is trying to tell you for these specific readings, my Tauruses. Okay, so now let's look at what is the gift of the month. And we're going to be using an oracle deck for that. Finding out, now we have a little bit of an idea of, you know, what the theme of the month is. Let's see what is the gift of the month. We want some good news. We want something positive. What is going to be the gift? Especially when it's your birthday month. We love gifts, right? Who doesn't love gifts? So of course this doesn't have to be material gifts, it can be spiritual, emotional, we'll see. And it says mycelium or mycelium, I don't know how you say it, but it represents this kind of organism, living organism between different mushrooms, and how they can cohabit and make this beautiful living place where a lot of growth and birth is coming out of. And what this card is telling you is that the gift of the month is very much so around creating a new world. If mycelium represents this idea of growth of those mushrooms, like making up this new coexistence of life, this could be the gift for you, my Tauruses. Out of the, you know, because you're leaving the past behind, you can create a new world for yourself. You can create a new environment. So maybe for some of you, you're going to be moving to somewhere new and start with new energies, create this new material world around yourself. Maybe for some of you, you're changing how you physically look. You're deciding to, very literally, like this card, change your hair or change the way you dress, etc. For some of you, it could be a lot deeper than that, and you're deciding to change the way you think and break some habits and starting to embrace a new part of yourself. Maybe you're starting a new hobby and you're deciding to go fully deep into that. Maybe you're starting a new relationship, or there's this sense of new growth, of newness, and of, again, this phoenix image is the thing I keep seeing for my Tauruses, which is beautiful. Okay, it's starting to rain, so hopefully you won't hear that too much, but I live on a tropical island, so when it rains heavy, you guys. It's monsoon season, but hopefully it won't be too loud. We shall see. Okay, so let's pull one more card around the what you need to know for the month. Sorry, I have one that's still turned around. And then we look at those two cards we put on the side. Let's see. And we have happiness. Beautiful. So this particular deck is all about chromatherapy, or the, you know, therapy around color. So orange, this color orange could be a color that is encouraged for you to work with, to wear on your clothes, as jewelry, to invite color in your home, to invite to use as candle, like orange candles, orange crystals, whatever works for you. The color orange could really help you during this transformational time, my Tauruses, to invite happiness, and it can be a great ally and medicine for you for the month of May. Beautiful. Okay, so we're going to be checking out those two cards now and seeing what the message from your guides is and from your higher self. So for the people who picked pile number one, or card number one right here, which was this beautiful kind of sun-like energy, the card underneath says tiger, and it says divine timing, good things come to those who wait. Beautiful. So if you're feeling a little bit impatient and like things are not going your way, my pile number one, remember that things will happen. You are on the right track. You are where you're meant to be. It's just in divine timing, not in your timing. So this is an invitation for patience for some of you, and look at different ways the tiger energy might come into your life. If you're seeing tiger on TV, if you're seeing it as emoji on social media, if you're seeing it on this bumper sticker on a car, whatever, different ways the tiger might come in your life, it will remind you of this specific reading and this specific message. And for my pile number two, card number two, people who picked this kind of butterfly purple gorgeous picture here, let's see what the message underneath says. And we have the giraffe, and it says the bigger picture, take a step back and gather your thoughts and feelings. So taking a bit of a perspective for the people who pick this card, looking at things from a higher viewpoint, just like the giraffe. Beautiful. And also, same as my pile number one, remember different ways the giraffe might come into your life, giraffe energy, in the month of May, seeing when you see giraffes, etc. Not literal ones, because depending on where you live, that might be hard, but you know, on TV, on social media, etc. You'd be surprised different ways. Maybe you'll even see the word giraffe in a book, etc., etc. Okay, my Tauruses, this is all I have for you. I really hope you enjoyed this specific reading. If you did, make sure that you leave my video a thumbs up or a comment. It really helps me out. And until my next video, I am sending you lots and lots of good vibes, and keep navigating the waves of your soul. Bye!